This Headless Professor video is about how to distinguish between primary or secondary reinforcement. And the answer lies in this key question. Which needs of the organism are being met by the reinforcement provided? Primary reinforcers are unlearned. The organism doesn't have to learn how to appreciate their value. Secondary reinforcers are learned insofar as the organism has to learn how to appreciate the value of those reinforcers. One of the greatest mistakes students make is they assume that since all conditioning is learning, anytime the organism has had to learn a new response in order to get reinforcement, the reinforcer must be secondary. That's not what we mean. Secondary reinforcement means that the value of the reinforcer had to be learned before this conditioning even took place. Some examples of primary reinforcers that are not learned would be any experience of direct pleasure or pain. This doesn't have to be learned. It's hardwired into the brain. Certain things like food and cocaine directly deliver these pleasures to the brain. Indeed, anything that meets a basic life need could be regarded as primary reinforcers. Food would be a good example, and we see this in most of the conditioning of laboratory rats. Whether in a Skinner box, where the primary reinforcer is food, or rats running a maze, again, where the primary reinforcer is food. Secondary reinforcement usually involves social-based reinforcers, such as approval of others, or the kind of self-esteem that we've learned within a given society. Our whole idea of appreciating winning in competitive activities would be a secondary reinforcer. Money is another example, because we have to learn to appreciate the value of money, that it can be used in exchange for other valuable things, including some primary reinforcers. So this is a table from your book showing the different types of primary and secondary reinforcers, those that are positive by providing something the organism appreciates, and those primary and secondary reinforcers that are negative because they take away or avoid something the organism does not want, the aversive stimulus of pain or embarrassment. Let's take an example here. The organism is the customer. The response is going to a coffee place and purchasing a cup of coffee. That's the response. What kind of reinforcement is the customer getting? Well, to the extent that the liquid is necessary for the maintenance of life, and that the brain is hardwired to appreciate caffeine, you might say this is a primary reinforcer. On the other hand, if the individual is primarily attending this coffee shop for social interaction, then we could say that the reinforcement also has a secondary aspect as well. Let's take the case of this yoga class on Lake Michigan in Chicago. Now, to the extent that yoga gives us a sense of achievement and accomplishment and social interaction, it would be getting several different forms of secondary reinforcement. To learn more about primary or secondary reinforcement, read pages 98 and 102 in your textbook. You can view the textbook online, or you can download a free copy in PDF or other formats.